Hi, welcome to the Shelley Studio and another Creative Arts Collaboration event. And this one is hashtag Love Spring Art. Looking forward to spring. And so I decided to create a still life slash landscape of some flowers, of course. When you think about spring, what else do you think about? I love flowers and I love spring. I love all the colors. So that is what I'm going to try and create today. And I am just using acrylic craft paint. Most of them are just the cheap craft paint from Walmart and Michaels. There's quite a variety, so I probably won't get the colors for all of them. If there's a particular color you see that you like, you can let me know and I'll try to figure out which one that was. And I'm just using a natural sponge to get sort of a foliage background going here. It has lots of bumps on the sponge, so it makes great texture. On the paper I'm using is Strathmore mixed media paper, and it really held up well to the acrylic paint. Of course, I didn't add a lot of moisture. I did the paint straight out of the bottles, but I really liked it. It was nice to paint on. And there you saw me using the brush to get a straight line to make sure my edges of my pot were parallel to each other. Now I'm just putting one on the side here. My perspective's kind of off on the one laying on its side, but yeah. I wasn't actually looking at a pot on its side, so I didn't have a reference for that. I am doing this really, really fast because the original video was very long. And a few times I ran out of memory on my memory card. So it does jump every once in a while when I'm just going along painting and not noticing that the camera has stopped recording. Hopefully it's not too dramatic. Like right there, nice jump. Oh, I was just getting in the base coat for those terracotta pots, and then I'll go over it with, I think this is peach, and parchment is the white color. Antique parchment is the white color. So this particular painting took quite a while to complete. It had tons of little details, and I did it in several stages and just let things dry. I didn't use the blow dryer on it. Well, I do at the end when I get into the flowers, because I didn't want to wait. And it was getting close to the start of the hashtag event. So don't forget, after you watch this video, to go into YouTube and search hashtag LoveSpringArt, and you will find all the great artists that are creating videos for this event. And you can see all the fun creations they are making. And I'm sorry, I do spin this around a lot because I do what angle is best for my hand and to get the right curve. So that's the one nice thing about having it on a table rather than on an easel. I can just spin it around, and I do. I turn this thing a lot. And I'm sorry if it makes you dizzy. I'd never really painted a terracotta pot before, and I was looking at one on Google. I googled images and found one to give me the coloring. And I was really pleased with how these terracotta pots turn out. Maybe not proportions so much, but the actual color and texture that comes with all these different colors that I add to this. And that's a little bit of dry brush technique, so you get sort of the distressed, aged look to it. I noticed when I was looking at the terracotta pots that where water has sat in them and the salts from the water have seeped through, it leaves white marks on the pot. So I tried to represent that a little bit. I'm sorry this video is kind of long, but I didn't think I could make it any faster than what I'm making it and have it be something you'd want to watch. So now what I'm doing is trying to make the ground look like it goes back rather than sitting flat. So I'm just shading the back area. And I get too carried away, you'll see. Decide it looks too smooth and pavement-like, and I wanted it more gravelly looking. So I take my texture sponge again, my natural sponge, and I just go to town on the ground. Oh, no, this one I used the makeup sponge, that's right. I figured the texture sponge would be too small, so I twisted up the makeup sponge and went over with that. and I'm making branches for a rose bush. I know some of the branches are brown, but I probably should have put some that were a little more green. But at least these show up really well against the green background. So I think there I was just trying to create somewhere for the leaves to sit on these branches. Wasn't thinking about thorns quite yet. This does take a while, putting leaves all over this rose bush. And I end up using mostly the Kelly green because the lighter green blended too much into the background. Remember what I said about spinning my picture? Love to spin my picture around. Now I decided the roses needed thorns. I'm just putting a little tiny dot around to look like thorns. And now I'm getting the flowers ready. Putting the center on. I thought this might be a good way to kind of get placement of them and just have a base down. Decided the thicker red paint might cover up some of the leaves I'm painting over, so I added that, and then I added white, and then I ended up covering the whole base of that, and it wasn't working quite the way I wanted it to, so I keep trying to get it down the way I want. So here I'm trying another technique. It's called single stroke painting. I learned it from Donna Dewberry. I don't know if any of you have heard of that name before, but it's where you put light on one side of your brush and dark on the other side of your brush, and then you can do the darks and lights simultaneously. Took a class from her a long time ago. I did not, however, reference her instructions before I started these flowers, so they're not exactly the way she taught, but it did help a little bit to get more of the rose look, which I struggled with there for a bit. Really working at those roses, man. They were difficult. Sorry, that jumped a bit. Another point when I didn't realize my camera had stopped running. Jumped again. That's okay, you didn't need to see me struggle through all those roses anyway. And the little brush I am painting most of this with is one of my favorites. And it's by Plaid, and it says it's a number 4 round. It also says Donna Dewberry on there. So I did not realize this paintbrush was that old, because that was... pretty sure it was before the year 2000, so that's an old paintbrush. It's held up really well. And Here I'm just adding some more leaves. I felt there needed to be a little bit more foliage. Now I'm just putting like grassy sort of strokes in there, just because I feel like there needs to be something. Alright, and then on to our next item of business, and that is to put some dirt in our flower pots, which I probably should have done sooner, but you know. I debated this one, whether or not I should have like the dirt falling out, but I decided without a visual reference I'd have a hard time with it, so I just left the dirt packed tightly in the pot. Could happen. Maybe the plants are root bound, the flowers are root bound, and they're stuck. Trying to get that terracotta effect in the back. Not as beautiful as the front, but hey, you won't see much of it. I was trying to decide what kind of flowers I was going to put in my flower pot. And I'm just looking, I was looking at images on Google Images. So I do not have the names of these flowers. I apologize. I just went for what looked cool. And these ones have straight stems. What I was doing. I think I was going to put the leaves on, then I decided I would put the flower on first. And unfortunately, I picked a red flower to go in front of my red roses. Well, they're more pink, but you know. I guess I was really into red. So this February, Valentine's, you know, red works. And that was me putting down some of the heavy body acrylic paint so that it would cover up what was behind it. Because it was peeking through too much. These flowers just kind of had like fuzzy little points on them, so I'm just giving them a little highlight on one side and trying to make it look fuzzy. Skipped again. I added a little even lighter color. Felt like it looked, they weren't showing up much at all. And now we're going to go in and do the leaves. We're doing this one in a little bit of the single stroke style where I've got highlight on one side, dark on the other, and then just stroking those leaves in. And this brush doesn't hold a lot of paint, so I have to keep going back. I think I got my highlight and my dark mixed up there, so I had to wipe off the brush. that crazy plant. Now let's do some vines hanging out of our pot. We like vines, vines are fun. I guess if you've stuck with me this long, you're probably going to stick with me through the whole thing, but I apologize, this video is so long, I put so much detail into this picture. And this picture has an excessive amount of green. Adding a lavender colored flower. Trying to do the single stroke here with white on one side, purple on the other, so you get the highlight and shading at the same time. It's a little tricky on how you hold your brush when you do that. I'm just trying to make something that would work as a center for these flowers that maybe you can see a little bit. So I'll add some white to it. See it barely. And the side, the vines don't show up quite well enough, so I'm just adding a little bit of darker green to them. Flower. Trying to do like an orangish red. Not sure that I'd put those colors together in a flower pot if I was planting one, but I decided I needed something different. There you go. Orange and purple side by side. Your vines on this pot. Decided the flowers in this pot should be low growing flowers. They'd be less likely to fall out of the pot when it tipped over. I'm just adding a little green. I don't know that I was actually referencing a real flower there, but it looked real, it looked cute. Kind of a low-growing daisy type plant. Decided I wanted a yellow flower. I didn't give myself a lot of space, so these are just kind of circle-y flowers. My yellow paint's almost gone, that's why I just stick my brush in the bottle. I decided the little have something on the ground, so we're gonna put little purpley flowers coming out of the pot on vines. Decided you can't really see them, so I am going around them doing a little bit of shading. I'm using NeoColor 2 watercolor crayons and in the black and just going around the edges a little bit. It doesn't really work too well. I do it, but because of the acrylic, it doesn't soak in, it just sits there. And then when it's too dark, I blot it and then it basically goes away. I think it gives it a little bit of dimension, but not a ton. Just lifts it a little bit. And now I've decided my ground was flat again, so I am darkening the top again to get it to look like it's going back. So it looks like ground rather than a wall that it's sitting on. And this is just jet black, I believe, that's highly diluted. Now they say you're not supposed to do that with acrylic paints, but trying to get around those vines and flowers. Go spinning the thing again, trying to make that flower pot look like it's sitting down rather than on top. Sorry, did not realize my camera wasn't recording. I did an underpainting for these daisies because I wanted to use yellow and I knew that it would not show up against the green background. So I did do, and it's just soft body white acrylic paint that I painted the daisies in, and now I'm just doing yellow over the top. Oh, now I'm adding a little bit of orange near the center to give them some dimension. Makes them look a little bit less flat. So I'm just blending out that orange into the yellow. And then I decide to add a little orange to the leaves and stuff, so they'll have a little bit different color, green, than what's behind them, so they don't disappear completely. Decide to darken it, the stem, because I still couldn't see it. So give the stem a little bit of black and green. So finally, I'm working on the leaves of these daisies, and I'm just doing a kind of mixing yellow and green without making them completely blended, just to give them a little bit of a different texture, which I kind of like how those leaves turned out. They're interesting anyway. The daisies are dry, so I'm doing a second layer of petals in the white, which I will go over with yellow after they've dried. And this is my soft body white paint, so it's a little bit thicker than just the craft paint. And I kind of liked the daisies just like this, but you know, after I put the white on there, but I decided they should be yellow. So I do add the yellow back in after the white's all dry. Just a light wash of yellow. orange. Daisies I've seen have kind of green behind the center, so I thought I'd put a little green around there before I put the centers in. And now I'm just using white and the back of my paintbrush. I blotted them off a little bit because I thought they were getting too heavy. Get the back of this flower. Fussing with the stem some more. Okay, and then I start messing with some leaves. I could have kept going and fussing with this thing, but I think at this point we're gonna call it done. And thanks for sticking with me. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you like the close-ups. And if you did like it, please hit like. If you have any comments, I'd like to hear them. And if you'd like to see more, please subscribe.